Hello everyone and welcome to Imperia Online Podcast. My name is Mitko and in the next 5 minutes we will give you the World Cup. I would like to welcome my guest for this podcast. His name is Krum. He is an expert and he knows everything and everyone there is to know about the World Cup. The last World Cup in the age of conquest. Will it be the best?
Certainly, being the last one makes it a bit more special, a bit more appealing. Some highly motivated teams are here. They have grown experience, they have grown aware of the traps of the last edition. It should make for an interesting and intense tournament. It will be worth to watch.
So, the qualifiers are over. The tournament is on the way. Which are the major players in this competition? Do you have any favorites and why?
Well, we do have all the medalists from the previous editions. They are the teams always in battle for the prizes. We also do have some traditionally strong teams such as Turkey, as Poland, as Italy. I can't say I have any favorites because I would be accused that I am biased and I'm just an impartial observer.
So we can say that the usual suspects are here.
Definitely.
Okay, what about the Bulgarian-Brazilian drama we had in the qualifiers? Two of the major players in the qualification who were Bulgarians played and they were close to ranking in the top 15.
Yes, in fact they did admit they were Bulgarians. I don't think they were planning on doing some harm on the Brazilian team. I think they were going to play fairly, but after all, the decision was up to the rest of the Brazilian team. After some initial hesitation, they decided they would not accept these players. And I can understand that they want to take first place and they have to minimize the risks. Any foreigner is a risk.
Do you think the Bulgarian players could have been involved in this coup? Because we all know that IO players can be very ruthless when they want to achieve their goals.
No, I think it was a decision of those two players. Their own personal decision. I don't think the Bulgarian team was involved, and for good or for bad, there is no conspiracy this time.
Okay, the first 3 days of the tournament, all the players are under protection. They cannot spy and they cannot attack each other. What is the best course of action for any participant in the World Cup in these first 3 days?
To put it simply, the main goal is economic development. They have to boost their economy as much as they can. Take as much provinces as they can. The speed of the realm makes the growth unbelievable, almost unbelievable, and taking a province as early as possible gives an advantage. Also, better units. Having to defend with heavy units against light or even with elite units against heavy gives a huge advantage.
As we can see from the live feed, the Brazilians, the Croatians and the Romanians have already taken castles in the World Cup realm. Isn't it a little bit earlier to get a castle in the tournament?
That decision is a double-edged sword, in fact. The castles do provide for a nice variety of benefits, but the teams have to consider the costs. Maintaining a castle needs a huge army. You need to upgrade that castle. That means that players from the teams have to donate their own resources and their own armies for the alliance sake, which makes them vulnerable in their own empires. It will be an interesting thing to see how these teams manage the castles so early.
The Brazilians have already gained nearly twice the net worth points compared to the other teams. Do you think this tournament will be the Brazilian tournament?
Well, it certainly looks like it. I think it's too early to tell. The Bulgarian team, which was the champion in the previous two editions, is somehow falling behind, but I don't think they will surrender so easily. Furthermore, the other teams are just as hungry for glory as the Brazilian team. We just might see some anti-Brazilian coalition aim to bring them down, some guerrilla tactics, constant attacks, not letting them develop as they want.
Looking at the current top 10 ranking of the teams, we can see that there are not very many surprises. All the major players are here, as you said, except maybe the Dominican Republic. Why are they here?
The Dominican Republic are basically like a one-man army. They have one strong leader, very well developed economically, but the rest of the team does not do so well. They do not stand really a chance for winning something, and their chance for achieving something is diplomacy. As much strong as this leader is, he cannot take a full team. He cannot take on a full team of 15 players. So he has to put some diplomacy in the works, and maybe these teams will be able to qualify in the final 20 teams, which will be a good achievement for them.
So you think they are here to stay?
Oh, definitely.
Okay, so far the Bulgarians are laying low. Do you think they will repeat their tactics from the last tournament with making decisive blows and attacks in the last possible moment and taking all the castles they want in the very end of the game?
If the Bulgaria team wants to succeed, they must resort to surprise. I think it is the first time they have found themselves falling behind so much, and striking in the end is going to be their chance. But before that, they must find a way to stop the Brazilian growth. The Brazilian team is growing way too much beyond control. They have to find a solution for that. They are the champions still, so that gives them the benefit of the psychological factor. They are being feared.
Okay, what's your prognosis based on these first days in the tournament?
I think it's too early to give my prognosis. The tournament has just begun, and I really can't predict what turn it can take. It's quite unpredictable.
Okay, thank you very much, Krum. My friends, the World Cup has begun, and we will be on the top of everything that happens in this battle of all battles. To all the participants, good luck and strength and honor, brave warriors.